think one of the more interesting things that happened, and Jacoby from Papa Roach would tell you this happened too, and we were doing Scars by Papa Roach. He had gotten sober and he was singing the vocal, and I remember saying to him, and I felt really bad about it afterwards, I said, I really wish you weren't sober, because you sang way better when you weren't sober. And he got so mad at me, threw a bottle at me or something. I think we shattered the bottle or something got shattered. And I said to him, now go sing it now. And that's the vocal that you hear. He was just so angry. And I was really, I look back on it and I go, that was a really messed up thing to say. But it just shows you sometimes where, you know, the emotion comes from on things. Like, you almost have to, I knew he wasn't selling it. And I think he knew he wasn't selling it. And we just had to get him to sell it, you know? So the anger came out of that. Another interesting part was when we were doing The Reason with Hoobastank, and I was with Doug in the studio, and Doug was singing the opening lyric where he goes, I'm not a perfect person, and that part of the song. I'm not a perfect person. And he was singing it over emotionally. He was singing it melodramatically. And when the Lakers were in the finals, and we were, I was going back and forth and telling him, he's a big Lakers fan. We were going like score, vocal line, score, you know, like you wouldn't think that's happening in the middle of all this shit, but it was. But I said to him, you know what, why don't you just try singing this song like you're bored? Like, sing it less emotional. Just sing it conversationally. You're sitting across from your girlfriend or your wife, and you're confessing to her something. And I don't think you need to oversell that. And that's the vocal you hear, is this bored. That's the only thing time I've ever told a singer to sound bored on a vocal, was that vocal. And it really worked for him. So while we're doing My Chemical Romance, a couple really interesting things happened with the first single, I'm Not Okay. I was in the studio with the A&R guy, Craig Aronson, who passed away. But we didn't have really our first single. We had great songs, and the band was one of the hardest working bands I ever, every time I'd say something to them, we were in a dirtbag little place, man, on Selmar Avenue in Van Nuys, in a little tiny rehearsal hall. And every time I'd tell them to do something, I'd ask them to write a chorus or do something like that. They'd go back to the Oak Woods. I don't know if they stayed up all night, but they would come back and they would always have something. But we didn't have the single, but Craig comes up to me and he goes, listen, I've been listening through to their demos, and they were on cassettes, a cassette demo back then or something like that. He goes, I got to the very end of this cassette, and there's just Gerard singing this one line going, I'm not okay, I'm really not okay, I'm not okay, I'm really not okay. And he tells me this, and I looked at him and I said, that's the entire project right there. That's it. That's the brand. Like, that's it. So all we have to do is write a song around that, because Gerard was sort of the misanthrope at the time. And, you know, the video even showed that, you know, of the classroom video and all that stuff. So when we went in the studio, they wrote the song, they came back, and we go in the studio and we have a middle eight. We don't know what to do with the middle eight. And Plotnikoff is sitting there. I said, Mike, you know, why don't we do a guitar solo? And Mike goes, yeah, we should put some harmonies on it. I said, yeah, put some harmony on the guitar solo. It's really a good idea. So we end up with this Queen guitar solo. Kind of came out of nowhere. It wasn't planned. Like, nobody said we were going to sound like Queen or anything like that. It was just a solo with a harmony and everything like that. And then when we got to the end where it breaks down, he goes, I'm not okay. And I said, no, Gerard, say, I'm okay. I'm really okay. But sing it ironically, so it sounds like you're not okay, but you're telling people you're okay. I'm okay. So that was a pretty cool twist of words and that song just came together like that. It was one of those things where we were having so much fun doing it. The song kind of wrote itself. So, you know, that was a great moment.